Welcome to adaycooks.com. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. More videos are coming. In this tutorial, we are going to make a traditional tic-tac-toe. Tic-tac-toe has a grid of 3x3. It may be easiest to implement it by using a grid wheel widget. I've introduced the grid wheel widgets in this next game. Let's try something new in this video. I will directly draw O's and X's on a canvas. On a canvas, we can draw anything on it. It's a very powerful widget. In this video, the flooring widgets and function will be covered. They are canvas, custom paint, draw line, draw over, and theme data. In the main.dats file, let's import the material library. In Flutter, 99.99% of programs require this material library. To launch the tic-tac-toe game, a main function is required. My app class is a stainless widget. Its home property is defined as tic-tac-toe instant, which will be implemented in the next step. The build function returns a material app. A theme data widget is used to define the theme of the whole app. Scatter background color defines the background colors of the scatter widget. I set the background colors as pale yellow. App bar theme controls the appearance of the app bar. There are a lot of settings for the app bar. I simply set its backgrounds to be blue accent. Tic-tac-toe is a stateful widget. It holds dynamic states of the application. Its createState function returns a private tic-tac-toe-state instance. Tic-tac-toe-state is a private state class. Its build function returns a scatter widget, which holds all widgets of the application. An app bar is defined in the scatter widget. The app bar is very simple. It only has a title called tic-tac-toe. The title is centered by setting the center title properties to true. I want to put the game board in the middle of the screen, so the body starts with a center widget. As the game board of tic-tac-toe is a square, aspect ratio widget is used to create a square container by setting the aspect ratio property to 1. The trial of the container is more interesting. It's a custom paint widget. It provides a canvas on which we can draw anything on it. Custom paint will ask its painters to paint on the canvas. We set the painters to be game painter, which will be defined soon. Game painter is a custom painter. There are two functions which must be defined. The paint function allows us to draw anything on the canvas. The should be paint function will tell the painter whether the canvas should be redrawn. In our case, we will continue to put O's and X's during the game. It can simply return true. Let's run the game. The theme data has done its job. The app background is pale yellow, and the app bar background is blue. The next step is to draw the game board, which is composed of 2 vertical lines and 2 horizontal lines. I want the game board to be as large as the screen width. I will divide the screen width into 3 parts and store the divide size into a variable. Other classes may also need to know the divide size. We can create static functions to return the divide size. Before drawing the game board, let's define the stroke width as a constant at the beginning of the file. Its lines have thickness now. Half stroke width will be useful if we want to know the actual dimensions of a slot. I want knots and crosses have a thicker stroke. I will also define the constant double stroke width. Go to the paint function of the game painter class now. The size parameter will tell us the size of the canvas. Since we have used the aspect ratio widgets to make our canvas to be a square, the width and height has the same size. We can get the divider size by dividing the canvas width by 3. To draw on the canvas, we need a paint instance defining the style, width, and color of the brush. Black paint is used to draw the horizontal and vertical lines. We are ready to draw our first horizontal lines by using the Drawline function of the canvas. The paint function will pass the canvas to us. To draw a line, we need the start and end positions of our paint instance. The Drawline function requires two offset instances for the start and end points. To instantiate an offline class, we need to set the X and Y values. I don't want the horizontal line touching the screen edges. I've added a stroke width as a margin for X1 and subtracted a stroke width for X2. The Y position is just the divided size from the top of the canvas. However, the stroke has a width. We need to move the Y position up for half the stroke width. X1 and X2 are the same for the second horizontal line, but the Y position becomes divided size times 2. For vertical lines, I also give Y1 and Y2 a margin of stroke width. X position is divided size from the left. Remember to subtract the half stroke width. The same for the second vertical line, except the X position is 2 times the divided size. When we save the file, Flutter will hot reload the game. Yay! We have the game board now. The next step is to draw O's and X. O's is also called as nodes. Let's define a draw node function in the game painter. To draw a circle, we can use the draw oval function. The function accepts different types of parameters. I will use rectdoc from ltwh functions to define the circle. It uses top, left, width, and height as parameters. Internally, we use an index to locate the line positions of tic tac toe. If we divided the index by 3 and take the remainder, it will give us the column index ranging from 0 to 2. By multiplying the number by divided size, we can get the left position. On the other hand, if we divided the index by 3 and take the integer value, it will tell us the row index ranging from 0 to 2. By multiplying the number by divided size, we can get the top position. To make the drawing better, I will give both the left and top some margins. Similarly, I don't want the knots and crosses touching the lines. I make it a bit smaller than the divided size. I will use two diagonals to draw a cross. Again, I will use modular operations and integer divisions to get the start and end positions of a diagonal. Of course, I will use the double stroke width as the margin during the calculation. I want to use different brush size and colors to draw knots and crosses. Let's create a black thick paint which is black, but has a thicker stroke. This thick black line is used to draw a cross. I also create a red thick paint to draw a knot. At the beginning of the file, let's define a mark enum. In tic tac toe, there are 3 possibilities in each slot. An O, an X, or nothing. In Tic Tac Toe state, I will use the maps to store the game status. The key is the index. It can be 0 to 8. The value is a symbol, which can be a knot, a cross, or nothing. In our game, the first player always use knots to play. The game must get input from the player. Gesture detector is a good option. I rub the aspect ratio by a gesture detector. Then I look for the on tap up event of the player. If the player lifts up a finger, it will add a mark in the map. Our map uses index as the position, but the on tap up functions can only return an X and Y values to us. We need to do some conversion. That's why I create the add mark function. In the private add mark function of the tic tac toe state, it will get the divided size first. Then it will apply integer divisions to x and y values and get the index of the game board. I use putIfAbsent function of the map to ensure each slot only has one symbol. After adding a mark, it will toggle the current mark from x to o and from o to x. We have just changed the internal state of the game. We need to draw the status on the screen. In order to pass the game status to the game painter, we will modify the constructor. Go to the build function of the tic-tac-toe state. Then pass the game marks to the game painter. Go to the game painter. It should have a map to store the game marks. Then change its constructor parameter to accept a map of marks. At the end of its paint function, it will read the whole map and call either draw not or draw cross function. It should work now. Save and launch the game. It works properly, but how can we restart the game? Let's say, if the game board is fully filled, the game mask map will be cleared. The first player's mark will be set back to a not. It's almost perfect! However, the game knows nothing about the winning rule. Let's go to define it now. In the tic-tac-toe state, define a variable called underscore winning line. It will store the three indexes of the winning line. While we are in the tic-tac-toe state, let's also modify the restart rule. If it is a tie or there's a winner, an additional tab will restart the game. We should also reset the winning lines to null. After drawing all the marks, the game should also draw the winning line if any. We will create a function called getWinningLines to check and return the three indexes of the winning line if a winner is found. There are 8 winning lines in total. I use a two-dimensional array to store them. Let's define a variable called winningLineFind to store the find winning line. Then the program loops through all the 8 winning lines and counts how many O's and X's on each line. If either there are 3 O's or 3 X's, the function will return the 3 indexes of the winning line. If there's no winner, winningLineFind variable will be null. Goes to tic-tac-toe state. Pass the winning lines to game painter as well. In the game painter, there should be a variable to store the received winning line. Of course, its constructor should accept the winning line parameter. Goes to the game painter class. Make a new paint brush for the winning line. It's a thick orange line. Ref change all internal state. Let's also ask the paint functions to draw the winning line. The paint function will call the drawWinningLine function. The function requires a canvas, a list of indexes of the winning line, and the paint instance. If the winning line is null, nothing can be drawn. Among the 8 winning lines, there are 3 vertical lines, 3 horizontal lines, and 2 diagonals. We need to use the first and last indexes of the winning lines to determine its directions. Then the game draws one of the vertical winning lines based on the first and last index. We do the same for the horizontal winning lines. The diagonals are a bit more complicated because their drawing methods are different. Finally, we call the drawline function. Hooray! We have finished the whole tic-tac-toe. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.